protein power. I know, you guys have been eyeing my muscles.
Kidding, kidding.
But did you know your body needs protein to heal? And it is crucial for the immune system, appetite control, muscle synthesis, right? Protein ensures that your gut lining will be appropriately constructed, and there will actually be enough building material for your enzymes. Because studies have shown over and over and over that inflammation actually went down in people that added lean meats instead of carbohydrates to their diet. So your body needs about 80 to 120 grams of clean protein per day, and that is obviously depending on your age, your body composition, activity level, but it's really essential to get protein in every meal or snack, whether it's from a vegetarian source or an animal source. Eating protein increases your metabolic fire and the ability to burn calories while reducing your appetite, helping you feel full, right? So we talked about that list, vegetables, protein, healthy fats. So after vegetables, we gotta make room for at least 4 to 6 ounces of meal, of protein per meal. But remember, everybody is different. So if you feel more fatigued or you're exercising a lot more, you might need a little bit more protein depending on your certain situation. But what I really want to emphasize to you guys is that the quality is more important than the quantity. So always choose clean protein. And that could be from, you know, a small wild caught fish. Those are highly nutrient dense and are a great source of omega-3s, vitamin D, B12. So I always like to consume those small fish, like the wild, sustainably raised cold water fish that includes like wild salmon, mackerel, sardines, herring, small halibut, anchovies, black cod. So there's so many amazing fish out there. I even have them stuck in my pantry for just in case purposes. And then you want to focus on those pasture-raised, non-GMO, are an excellent source of choline that's needed for burning out the detoxification, are full of antioxidants and minerals and vitamins, especially folate. Eggs can even protect you against heart disease. It's crazy. So you're not allergic, you're sensitive. Now meat. It's a gray zone, right? And there's both sides of the story. But we really need to focus on quality, not quantity. Because it's a grain-fed animals that are inflammatory, and grass-fed animals are full of micronutrients. So make sure that the meat that you're eating is grass-fed, grass-finished, but remember, we talked about the non-veggie options, but there's so much vegetarian options out there, like hemp seeds and chia seeds, lentils and beans, pea proteins, if you can tolerate them. Now, protein powder. I get that question asked a lot. You want to opt for at least as possible when you're looking for protein powders. So instead of all those concoctions, simple. Egg protein powder, collagen, gelatin, beef, hydrolyzed protein. All of those are amazing sources that will help your gut lining. And, you know, if you can't eat the clean protein, always look for the vegan protein. So if you're sirloin, turkeys, chicken breast, avoiding the cuts and meat with lots of fat and fat around it, because it's on that harbors a lot of the toxins. Remember, I would avoid corn because it harbors like viruses in processed meats. I would also avoid like ham and bacon and sausage because they've done studies where all this processed meat actually increases the risk of cancer. So remember, I know I told you a lot of stuff here, but a little goes a long way. So to make sure that you're getting enough vegetables, because plant-based is key, but you still need some sort of protein. And as you can